Brood, that's right.
Plant, yeah.
Yeah, I have watched. I have seen Brood. Hopefully, we can get him over here in U.S. soon with that plant. So we're going into game one here on Battlefield of all stages, and we got a Ridley on the other side.
We got Cheeto versus Cheeto. They're both playing Cheeto colors, man. So Kofi prides himself on being extremely disciplined and how to deal with heavies. Most Falcos are, you kind of have to play traditionally very safe against. Falco also has an immaculate combo game on heavies. It's not, it's very typical that you will see.
Look at this right here.
You will see Falco take a heavy from 0 to 80 in an instant. So
there was a couple points in that where it was just like a good call on Kofi, and he extended it all the way to 96 afterwards. Like, that's the huge detriment that Ridley's gonna have to do it. Here's the thing though, you get caught by a Ridley F smash like so, you could die at like 50 at the ledge. That move is strong. But so is that up tilt the back here. Kofi taking the first point.
I think that's true too. Don't quote me on it. I don't know. Yeah,
some of those really windows are true, okay. Yes.
Yeah, that's insane.
That's one of his best kill confirms he's got going for him right now.
And it's such a good aerial too. Yeah, you can fall if you can fall out of it, but if you fall out of it, it literally combos back into itself.
Mm-hmm. Oh, this should be a pretty hefty punish here.
Yeah, absolutely. If I'm Kofi, I'm eating all that percent up for dinner right now.
Yeah, and there's nothing that Emerald Drummer could really do in that situation as well. Oh, he's
double,
gonna go for
double
it again. Hey, you know what? It was the right call, but it was too far. Emerald Drummer knew if he jumped there or pulled it early, he was dead. But Kofi's going to take that regardless.
Oh, here we go again. Okay, he didn't get the perfect drag down window. Down smash coming out. A great option. Emerald looking for options, though, to just get out of there. It can feel really tough when you're up against a Spacey because they have this sort of smothering combo game that you really can't get out of. And as a heavy, you have to be used to the oppression.
Yeah, and there's also something that there's been a huge... There it is! You remember the big green button on
where
he's airborne? The fact that he hasn't really been using too many down tilts and nairs to try and space him out, he's finally starting to remember, finally getting a dash attack, putting himself on the board.
The numbers are definitely coming back, Mason. Oh, okay, very good. Now, what Emerald is doing a good job of right now, until he just dropped it, was he had center stage in the palm of his hand for a bit. I do agree with the big green button comment. He's going to be wanting to use that a lot. I'm also loving these approaches. Oh my god, down smash. No, okay, good. Good roll away right then. You never see that move hit, like, ever.
Yeah, there's a lot of people, like, who you don't play against Ridley too much. So if you haven't realized by now, you can get out of there.
He's dead.
All right, that's it, yeah. It's such an awkward recovery that Ridley has for being such
it's so weird. He should have more than two directions. Right? He only has horizontal and vertical, right?
Yeah, it's really weird. It's like a downward angle on the up B2.
Yeah, it's so weird.
So it looked like he was starting to get a little bit life there afterwards. He was throwing a lot of Hail Mary hits.
Yeah.
I think it was just he was getting so pressured so like much that he was just trying to find a way out. You gotta keep your composure in those situations. If you run into a player who's comboing you like crazy, it's like, you know what? I'm gonna have to eat this damage, especially as a big body. This is going to happen no matter what.
Exactly.
Let me go ahead and just keep my cool and run it back.
That's the mentality you really have to apply to this, honestly. I am going to get hit. That is a fact. I am not JV3 this man with Ridley. I'm going to get hit. I have to be able to be willing to eat this damage and really just dig deep. Because if you're eating that much damage and you tend to get flustered, you've already lost your stock. It's already over.
Exactly. The moment you start panicking, all you're doing is not only are you giving yourself free damage to your opponent, but your opponent is now realizing, oh, they're very hectic out of disadvantage. I'm going to constantly read their jump, but it's just not going to work for you. Now we got the FD swap here. He keeps recovering to the center stage or so with Uppy. He's got us calmed down with those.
Wow. The pillar combos. My man is pillar comboing in this game. That's wild. People always say that fighting Falco is like playing a cutscene Smash game. Once Falco gets you in that up tilt, the cutscene begins.
Mm-hmm. Agreed. And Kofi is one of them that gets that going big time, trying to swing big time again. Oh, just going for the read off of that down side
that
B.
Wild.
He was gonna jump or a side B or something. Finally catching him with that spike he was looking for.
So Kofi didn't really have a main in 4. I think Falco's just a character where he's really coming to his own as a player. You'll see him locally too. He has a very nice Dark Pit and Roy he's been sporting recently.
He's definitely a random master for sure.
Yeah.
But right now it doesn't matter because everything is not random on his decision chair. Trying to go for another down air right there. Emerald Drummer just having a hard time finding his way back to some real estate in the back center stage.
You're watching someone taking the SATs for the first time. Wasn't had any prep classes.
They forgot their calculator.
Yeah, exactly. It's looking rough.
Speaking from a personal experience right there. Never forget your calculator, kids, when you go to SATs.
These unorthodox recoveries by Emerald leave a little flustered. Maybe he's not used to playing on stream, or maybe he's not used to playing on a
potentially, but you also got to give testament to the fact that Kofi's just, he understands how this works. A lot of people will run into big bodies, and they get frightened every time they get hit. Kofi, in no way, shape, or form.
Dude, against Kofi, the cutscene is unskippable. You are sitting through that cutscene, and you are learning that dialogue and story to the T.
Looking like a Mortal Kombat combat video out here, and combo video, excuse me. Trying to go for the neutral B to set him up, and he was hoping to maybe catch him going high. Doesn't matter, though. That's going to be it. Another three stock coming in on stream. Kofi going to take it over Emerald Drummer. You can see him. He's definitely got that surprise. Yeah. Like, wow. It's not many times where you could run into a very solid Falco, but there it is.
You have to be very relaxed when it comes to Falco. You have to, like, you have to know how to work within his area of space. If you enter, he has a great anti-air built into his kit with up tilt. If you're in front of him, he can even scoop you up. You have to play. You have to kind of kite him along. You have to wait for Falco to really overextend on you.
Yeah.
You can't be making the first
move
most of the time.
You almost need to force them into a situation where they're fishing for up tilt confirms too much.
Yeah.
Because if you can start to take away their main toolkit, a lot of players will crumble under that pressure. Obviously, Kofi is not one of those players.
He's a very calm, cool, collected player.
Yeah, you get a lot of people who get too antsy. It's like, play against the Ike matchup or something like that, right? If you remove their ability to get the Nair, then now they have to force them to play harder.
That's what
you
I'm
take
saying.
Away good recovery options from someone like Wolf. Well, now what do I do? Like, you got to force them into a spot where they feel super uncomfortable, not just kind of attack them, like, just scot-free.
Falco's also a character.